comment on the Victorian Government's Women's Pain Inquiry, former Liberal MP, now candidate for Boothby, Nicolle Flint. Well, Nicolle, thank you for your time. This is a personal one, but I know you put it out in the public sphere. You were very, honest, I think, and upfront about the fact that endometriosis was one of the contributing factors to your departure from politics. I know you've got it under control. We're good friends, but a lot of other women don't. Hence this inquiry into Victoria about how the system can better support women with chronic issues like this. What do you make of this call, though, for submissions from biological men who identify as women?
Look, Peter, I've really run out of words to describe circumstances like this. It's extraordinary, it's offensive, it's disgraceful, and there is no reason for biological men to be part of this inquiry. If you don't have a uterus and all of the, if you're not a biological woman and you don't have all of the things that can go horribly wrong, as they did for me, as they do for so many women, then there is no need for you to be part of this inquiry. So endometriosis, I look back and you're right, I have been very public about my journey. I was in chronic pain for, 30 years, 35 years of my life. I am so grateful to now have that under control. There are so many women who don't have it under control, who are still, for example, presenting to emergency departments and getting accused of being searching for drugs, for pain relief, because still our medical community don't necessarily recognise or know how to treat endometriosis properly. Peter, I think about women who have had very traumatic birth injuries and lifelong consequences for that, and often lifelong pain. I mean, encouraging or inviting biological men to take part in this inquiry when you have women who have very genuine, very real, very lifelong chronic pain with no end in sight is just insulting.
It isn't a time we just call BS on all of this. I mean, I think it mocks the women that are in a position where you were, that have nowhere to turn. This is, they've fought for a long time to get this inquiry up. We can't just keep turning a blind eye to this anymore, Nicolle.
No, Peter, and let's remember who is ultimately responsible for this sort of thing. It's Julia Gillard and her government who in 2013 erased, deleted the definition of woman and women in the Sex Discrimination Act. So what we need to see is putting our definition back into the Act so that we can actually get the help, the assistance, and restore our rights to have our issues properly dealt with. And unfortunately, decades of neglect of women and women's pain by the health system is not really much better than it has been. But one of the reasons that I'm running again, Peter, is to try to change that once and for all.
Hey, just quickly, three words, four words, what are the key issues people are raising with you in Boothby?
Cost of living and a brand new one I've never seen, crime and community safety.
Wow. Wow. To see this, Australia, this is why we need her back in the parliament. I'm not in Boothby. If I was, I'd vote for her. Nicolle Flint, great to have your company.